In this video, I'll be walking you through how to build your first Google Chrome extension using vanilla HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. This extension allows you to remove the contents of any website when you click on the red button in the extensions pop-up. It doesn't matter your skill level for you to be able to follow along with this tutorial, as long as you understand the basics of building a website, which of course is HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. If it's your first time on the channel, kindly subscribe so that you'll be among the first set of people that will know when we drop new videos. Do not forget to like, share, and of course, drop your comments in the comment section. Let's get into it. So I've gone ahead to create the basic files that you need for this extension, and it includes a manifest.json file, a popup.html, and a popup.js. We are going to get to those later. First, let's focus on the manifest.json file. The manifest.json file is very similar to package.json in most JavaScript projects because it just contains basic information about your Chrome extension. So let me show you. You have an object here, of course it's JSON, then you have the name key, which represents the name of the extension. In this case, it's NewKit. Then the description basically contains information that's going to show up in the Chrome Web Store. I'm going to show this to you later. So the description for this is going to be remove the content of any website. Then the version of the extension. This is just for you to track the extension by yourself. So I'm just going to do 1.0. Then you have one very important key, which is the manifest version. This is very important. Please don't miss this out. And it's going to be 3. So 3 because this is the latest manifest version when building Chrome extensions, because it comes with security and a lot of speed and performance features that comes with it. After setting up your manifest.json, we try to have everything that you need to start building your Chrome extension. So up next, I'm going to show you how you can install this extension so that by the time you begin to write the code for the extension, you can test it locally. So I'm going to come over to my browser and I'm going to click on the extensions icon, click on manage extensions, then click on load unpacked. Then it's going to open up your file explorer. In this case, the name of the folder containing my extension is devfest.domashow. Click on select and you see that the extension is now showing up. It says new kit and the description is remove the content of any website. So the next thing I want to show you is, if you come over to the extensions tab here and I'll look for new kit and I'm going to pin it, right? If I click on new kit, is just going to show the name of your extension with a bunch of other options. Up next, we want to be able to show an interface or a UI that the user will see when they click on the extension, and that takes us to the next thing, which is known as pop-up. So when you open up an extension, that interface that you see when you open that extension is known as a pop-up. And in order to be able to do that, all I'm going to do is to come over here and add a new key called action. Then it's going to be an object and I'm going to add a key of default pop-up. Then the value is going to be our HTML file, that is popup.html. Save it up. Then let me check that there is an error here. It should be default pop-up. Then come over here and click come over here, refresh this guy, then click on it. Then you see we have a tiny box here. So we have a tiny box here which represents our HTML interface. So if I come over to popup.html, it means that I can begin to load this with more markup. And I'm going to do something very simple. I'm just going to come over here and add the main tag, then a paragraph, which is going to be want to see some magic. Save it up, come back here and click on this guy. You see, we have the text, want to see some magic. Up next, we need a button. That is what the user is going to click on in order to remove the content on the website. So I'm going to click on create a new tag and call it a button. Then the text inside of this is going to be click me with an exclamation. Come over here, check this guy, then click me. Then quickly, I want to add an ID. I'm going to call it milk. I'm going to call this button milk. Then create a style tag in here. I'm doing I'm dumping my style inside of this HTML file because we don't have a lot of styling to do. If you need to do a lot of styling, just create a new popup.css and link it with a link tag and you'll be fine. So I'm going to do style. Then I'm going to select this guy and call it new. Then I'm going to give it a width of 100 pixels. Then the aspect ratio, just to ensure that we have a box or a square, will be 1x1. Then the background color is going to be red. I'm going to remove the border so that we don't have those annoying gray outline that you have in buttons by default. So the border will be none. Then the border radius is going to be 50% in order to ensure that we have a round button. So if I come over here now and check this guy, you see we now have, want to see some magic, click me. On to the next thing. So right now, this button doesn't do anything. For now, I want to remove the content of the website. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over to pop-up.js and I'm going to select the button and I'm going to use a query selector for that. So I'm going to do const new button. Let's do camel case over there. New button equals document.query selector / milk. Then I'm going to add an event listener. This is vanilla JavaScript that you know and love. Add event listener. When the user clicks on this, we want to run a function. And right now, I'm just going to alert, show me the magic. Save it up and come over here. Click on this guy, click on click me. Boom. You have the button inside of the extension and it's doing something. How amazing is that? So on to the next thing. We want to remove the content of the website, right? So I'm going to come over to the YouTube tab here and click on milk. Click on me. Then okay, right? Then I'm going to, the syntax for this is actually very simple. You just need to do document.body.remove. Save it up and let's see what happens. Oops. So yeah, as you can see, you are removing the content of the plugin itself or the extension itself instead of the content of this website. And that's just because you are running JavaScript inside of the plugin, not inside of the browser tab. In order to be able to do that, you need access to the browser tab. And the way you have access to the browser tab is by giving permission to your extension to access the browser tab. I know I've said access a whole lot of time, pardon me. But then, let's just get into it. So come over to manifest.json and just add a new key called permissions. Permissions. This is going to be an array, and this is going to be an array of permissions that you want to grant to the extension. So in this case, we need access to the active tab so that, of course, we can remove the content of that tab. So I'm going to save this up and I'm going to come over to pop-up.js. Then I'm going to run a query on all the tabs on the website. I'm not to be able to do this. I'm just going to say chrome.tabs.query. So Chrome here is similar to the window object when you are building website. So you are creating a Chrome extension. So Chrome is a global object that has properties and methods that you can use to do a bunch of things. And in this case, we are trying to query all the tabs in our Chrome browser. I hope that makes a lot of sense. So we are going to run a query on the active tab. So you just pass active and say true. Then the current window should be true as well, right? But this doesn't say anything yet. I'm going to make this guy an async function because this guy here returns a promise. And what I'm going to do is to wait for this promise to resolve. And this promise returns an array. I know I'm saying a bunch of things now. Just stay with me and follow along. So this is going to return an array, right? So I can say let this array equals that. So I'm going to destructure the tab from the array. So I'm just going to say let tab, let this array, destructure tab from it, and wait for this query to run, returning the active tab and the current window. So I'm just going to do an alert of json.stringify of tab. The reason I'm doing json.stringify is because I've built a bunch of Chrome extensions, so I'm aware that this guy returns an object. So let me save this up, come over here to the extension. I need to comment this guy out so that it doesn't remove the body of the extension again. Click on this guy and click on it. So you see that this guy returns a bunch of properties about the tab, which is this current active tab. So what I need to do now is get the ID of this tab. So I'm just going to come over here and say const tab ID equals tab dot ID. Now we have access to the tab, but that's not the end of our problems because we need to be able to run a script in this browser tab. In order to be able to do that, we need to grant another browser permission to our extension. And the way we are going to do that, and the permission we need to grant to our extension is to be able to run scripts within the tab. So I'm going to come over to manifest.json and I'm going to add a new item to our array of permissions, and it's going to be scripting. So scripting basically allows us to be able to run scripts within our Chrome extension. So I'm going to come over here to popup.js, right? And I'm going to say Chrome again, the global object that you will learn to love, chrome.scripting.executeScript. Then it's going to accept an object. Then the first object we need to pass into this, or the first item that we need to pass into this object, is a target, which is which particular tab or which particular window are we do we actually want to execute the script. Then we are going to do target, and then we are going to pass an object to the target, which is the tab ID. Of course, it is ES6, that means we can remove this guy. And right now, the next one to do is, what script do we want to run here? For now, I'm just going to make this an anonymous function. And right now, I'm just going to say, alert, yay, we are in the tab doing awesome stuffs. Save it up. So come over here, click on this guy, and it alerts, yay, we are in the tab doing awesome stuff. So one thing you want to pay attention to is when you grant new permissions within manifest.json, ensure to come over to the extensions and click on this reload, or else the permission that you granted will not be granted. You need to refresh this guy. Okay, so let's go on to the next thing. Come over to popup.js, then I'm going to run this piece of code that we have commented out here, document.body.remove. Save it up and let's see some magic. Click on this guy, click me, boom, youtube.com is gone. How amazing is that? So of course, if you're a big fan of clean code, one thing you may want to do is to put this guy in a function. So I'm going to do this. I'm going to come over here and say const doomsday, because that's literally what's happening, equals this function that we have here, document.body.remove. Then I'm going to do doomsday. Save it up. Let's refresh this page and click on the extension, and it's gone. Congratulations! You just built your first Google Chrome extension. If it's your first time on the channel, kindly subscribe so that you'll be among the first set of people to know when we drop new videos. Do like, share, and of course, drop your comments in the comment section. I'm curious, would you like me to make more videos about Chrome extensions, maybe something much more complex using the Chrome storage and all of that? Please let me know in the comment section as well. Cheers, and don't forget to build like a boss.